Section 29, Vaisampayana said, "In the meantime, Bhimasena, also endued with great energy, having obtained the assent of Yudhishthira, the just marched towards the eastern direction, and the tiger among the Bharatas, possessed of great valour, and ever increasing the sorrows of his foes, was accompanied by a mighty host, with the full complement of elephants, and horses and cars, well armed and capable of crushing all hostile kingdoms. That tiger among men, the son of Pandu, going first into the great country of the Panchalas, began by various means to conciliate that tribe. Then that hero, that bull of the Bharata race, within a short time vanquished the Gandhakas and Videhas, that exalted one, then subjugated the Sarnas there in the country of the Sarnas. The king called Sudarman, with his bare arms, fought a fierce battle with Bhimasena, and Bhimasena, beholding that feat of the illustrious king, appointed the mighty Sudarman as the first in command of his forces. Then Bhima, of terrible prowess, marched towards the east, causing the earth itself to tremble with the tread of the mighty host that followed him. Then that hero, who in strength was the foremost of all strong men, defeated in battle Rochamana, the king of Ashwamedha, at the head of all his troops, and the son of Kunti, having vanquished that monarch by performing feats that excelled in fierceness, subjugated the eastern region. Then that prince of the Kuru race, endued with great prowess, going into the country of Pulinda in the south, brought Sukumara and the king Sumitra under his sway. Then O Janamejaya, that bull in the Bharata race, at the command of Yudhishthira, the just marched against Sisupala of great energy. The king of Chedi, hearing of the intentions of the son of Pandu, came out of his city, and that chastiser of all foes then received the son of Pritha with respect. Then, O king, those bulls of the Chedi and the Kuru lines thus met together, inquired after each other's welfare. Then O monarch, the king of Chedi offered his kingdom on to Bhima and said smilingly, "O sinless one, upon what art thou bent?" And Bhima thereupon represented unto him the intentions of King Yudhishthira, and Bhima dwelt there, O king, for 30 nights, duly entertained by Sisupala. And after this he set out from Chedi with his troops and vehicles. Thus ends the 29th section in the Digvijaya Parva of the Sabha Parva.